really, really cool paint tricks I'm gonna show you for this project. Alright, so you saw me print out my Titan the other day, and this is my Atlas model, and I finally got a chance to paint him. I've been just jonesing to get a chance to paint this guy. So for this project, I've used two really, really easy tricks. The first one, to get kind of the illusion of detail, the digital pattern on my Titan, I used one of my favorite tricks of all time, paint tricks, is I call it the laundry bag trick. And laundry bags, you can get these at Walmart and get them anywhere, man. They're like $3, and they have a really cool hexagonal pattern to them, and they make the easiest stencils to use for anything, for camo, things like that. So that's the first trick I'm gonna show you. And then the second trick, this is why model guys hate airbrush guys, because with an airbrush, one of the easiest things to do with models is make them look weathered. I mean, it's almost like cheating. It's so easy, and I'll show you how to do it. All I really did was I started with a little bit of a lighter color, which was my gray, and then I went over it with black. And remember, I'm using Wicked, so it is water-based paint, so it rubs off really easily before you set it with a clear coat. So the trick is you go into all the little nooks and crannies with black. All right, and you get right in the nooks and crannies, and it's so stinking easy with an airbrush to do this. Then I come back with a toothbrush and just some paper towels, and I rub down my model with the toothbrush, and it gives it this amazing weathered metal look, and it's so, so easy. So those are the two tricks I use for this project. I can't wait for you to check it out and see how awesome this little guy came out. That's pretty much it. I'm glad you got a chance to check out this super easy project and how awesome it is to paint giant robot monsters. So, if you got any questions, you know where to check us out, man. I'm still at Airbrush Tricks. I'm Tony D.